language does not kill me, can only make me stronger. For real. I don't see why everybody feel as though they gotta tell me how to live my life. You know? Let me live, baby. Let me live.
What's going on, everybody? I want to thank you guys for tuning in to this week's episode of Hoshily Awkward. I'm just going to go ahead and log into Facebook here because I'm not suspended for once.
She's free.
Oh, fuck. What's my password?
Goddamn.
Oh, man, because they made me change it.
So what?
What did it do?
What did you do with your time when Facebook was down for no reason whatsoever?
And when you get high, you would think of some shit.
We know we are related to you. You have you have said some of the most off the wall shit.
Like, bro, just think about how, like, when you watch the news, like the news, mm-hmm. that shit is for like important shit, like the government shutting down or just, you know, shit of that nature.
Hey, Facebook shutting down is very important.
Right, that's what was crazy.
Share this shit and tag me in it because I don't feel like trying to remember
that shit made national news. All
right, I got you.
Like, who would have thought a fucking social media website was that important,
bro? Facebook is like the link to everything.
It is.
So, what do you expect?
I was just mind-boggling.
Okay, well, since we have been having random people mainly from YouTube, hi YouTubers, we are gonna go ahead and actually introduce ourselves this week. Now, I am your host and favorite motivational speaker, Mimi Sub-100, or Kummer Walker, if you're nasty. Now, I know that I look like, you know, an L.A. gangbanger tonight, but there's a method to my madness. But
you are definitely you like the one Indian of them bitch. Learn to survive in South Central.
It is what it is. Then we got Pod Guy Fresh and Mr. Tone Deaf of the Deaf Fresh Show. I have...
You I'm look not, like you musty.
I am so fresh.
Just like with the durag and the mask on.
I am so fresh.
You have on black dookies.
Oh, God. Like, you look like a motherfucking troublemaker.
Pretty damn near close.
Like, you look like a fucking troublemaker.
I got on my whole Adidas fit, my Adidas.
Yeah, your whole Adidas fit.
Yeah.
All day you dream about sex.
That is correct. Yeah, I even got the Adidas pants.
Lisa, you know what? I respect you for completely matching. Unlike some people who have on like Nike flip-flops with Adidas sweatpants and a Puma shirt.
Hey, man, you wear what's comfortable.
You be pump faking. You still ain't get your stuff from dude. He must don't know you don't drive.
I'd explain that to him.
And you can't just get up on a whim and go pick up your shit.
Right. And then he said, well, would it be easier if I ship it to you?
Then just ship it.
That's what I said. I was like, yeah.
As much as he knows we record.
That's what I'm saying.
You can't just ride down the SP.
He come down here and hang out with Scales all the time.
But he can't just ride down here. He knows the show is on because
he's watching.
What?
Oh, I forgot that was straight for a minute. Stunk a little bit.
You were straight. Oh.
That shit smells straight. That shit got a bicep. It's strong.
I'm in a good mood today, y'all.
I see.
I'm in a very, very, very good mood.
So am I.
I'm so sorry that we had to start late today, but as you know, when booty calls, it is what it is. So I had some dick deliveries to do, and Kummer's Candy Closet is here. Hoshily Awkward is, you know, just... Hoshily Awkward don't make me money. As much as I love talking to y'all every week, this is not a source of income. Kummer's Candy Closet is, so... We know who has
you know anytime you want to skip a week on fucking grossing us out, we'll take it.
Facts.
Mimi can fit some. So what the fuck you trying to say? Huh? What you trying to say?
That he wants you to come wear some of his clothes, I guess. I don't fucking
know. He talking about some she could fit it now, like all that fat bitch. No, I'm kidding, bro. I'm kidding. Nah, it felt good, man, to be able to be a little Slim Jimmy. Not really though. Like I'm in the 150s again though. That's
great job on that.
That's nice. That feels good.
Tom, I'm proud of you.
You don't work there anymore.
I can
I'm off camera on
the
weekend.
I can bounce on dick a little bit longer now.
That's just nice.
Without
nice
the little beads
shirt,
of sweat coming down from the lace front.
Said it's quality.
You telling me you ain't got a fresh time t-shirt at the crib you throw on laundry day?
Hey, you damn sure got a fresh time hat behind my couch that I can't reach.
Facts.
Yeah.
We had a bunch of them in my trunk.
The only thing I think I...
They didn't charge you?
What?
For continuously needing...
Hats and shit. He probably took it from other employees.
Like, some shit they be wanting you to buy... Like, they really only want you to buy the expensive shit.
I don't know. I think I lost the cup size. I might not be a triple D no more. I might be a double D now.
See, the jobs that sell you, like, merchandise, they only want you to buy the expensive shit. So, like, when it's cold outside... Or you want to buy a fleece so you can go in the freezer. That's the shit that they won't give you.
Yeah, that's the shit they should give you. What if this person can't afford it and now they ain't here working out?
They take it out your check.
That's kind of smart, but yet terrible.
They give you a form to fill out, and then, like, if you buy $50 worth of shit, your check will be $50 short.
I feel like I got to get a subscriber something special. Because they subscribed at 10:10 this morning. And today's date is 10-10.
10-10-10-10.
Yeah.
Happy Mental Health Day.
Oh, is that?
Yeah.
Shout out to the Michael Myers of the world.
Something like mental health, bruh.
He mental as a motherfucker.
Okay.
He's autistic. He has no control over that.
He a little bit of both. A little bit of A, a little bit of B.
Why am I related to you?
He's still my dog, though. I can't wait till the movie come out.
None of us can, bruh. So I went home and watched Curse of Chucky and The Cult of Chucky. Great movies. Terrible.
I just wanted to know, like, I was reading the group chat and I couldn't formulate the question because I was probably high, but I was like, why the fuck is Tone watching these goddamn Chucky movies? Because the questions came in so fucking random.
Monte brung it up for some odd reason. Because he asked us, did we watch The Cult? So I guess he must have just got done with it because they all on Peacock but the first one. Okay.
I was like, this nigga done went down a rabbit hole or some bullshit.
I just said, like, because The Cult, I actually like The Cult. But then I was like, I never watched The Curse.
First of all, it don't got dust on it because it's in the bag. Boom.
So I'm like, let me go and watch this, the one I missed. Then I started thinking about it. Like, dog, there was a point in time Chucky was almost a nigga.
Yeah,
like he got so sick and tired of Andy's shit.
Oh, and he was gonna jump in a black dude body.
Yeah. I'd rather be a black man and deal with oppression and then be stuck in his damn Dial's body.
Wait, so it's an actual black man?
No, it's a white dude.
No, because only
Chucky's a white dude.
No, I know that. Okay. What I'm saying is, you were talking about Cult. The only time I know he was trying to get into a black person.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Yeah, okay. Because I was going through the list.
This nigga was sick, dog. He really had little kids spraying each other on a paintball field.
Yeah, I seen when you said that.
Yo, that's...
Like, that's wild as fuck.
They had... The fact that they were having real-out paintball wars every year, though. And this nigga was like, hey, you know what'd be funny? We give them real bullets. And just swapped all their shit. First of all, that's not how paint guns work.
So since I'm currently looking at my mentions on Twitter, I'm going to jump right into something that I wanted to talk about today. Like, I am so sick
of the internet.
That entirely, yeah.
Don't God.
But I get it. I do porn. You know what I mean? I do OnlyFans. There are going to be people that reach out to me and, you know, say sexual things or try to sleep with me. I get it. That's part of the job. It's what happens. I think what annoys me the most is that a lot of niggas aren't honest with themselves. And the way that they come at you is just like, oh, well, let's work. Let's collab. And it's like, bro.
You know.
You have... no profile picture.
unknown as a bitch.
No profile picture. 6 fucking followers. And if you even have an OnlyFans link, it's like 1 post, 1 like.
Sound like a rap nigga.
But you're talking about some fucking let's collab. Bro, you are not a fucking content creator. You are a creep with a camera phone. There are differences.
Hey, damn. Depending on what kind of phone you got, these cameras are getting better.
He's still a creep, though.
He's a creep with a camera phone. See me?
I have real shit. Now, don't get me wrong. I still have my phone for, like, when I need certain things. I'm like, all right, let me go.
She bring the box today.
Gee, I don't know. She had a bag. I don't know what the fuck is in this bag.
But I'm saying. saying, like, I have actual quality cameras for my shit because I'm serious about my shit.
She invested in it.
Okay.
You know, okay, so I just had a random thought in the middle of, you
I'm holding almost $1,000 in my hand just from cameras.
And I can believe that.
Yeah, that's true. So, like porn stars or like any kind of sexual occupation is the only time you'll ever see a nigga volunteer to help someone at their job. Like, you will never see a nigga walk in and be like, damn, they shorthanded. Let me jump on fries. You'll never see that shit.
I don't think you could.
But a sexual occupation, niggas always want to participate.
I got a dick. I can do this.
Right.
Right.
It's like, just not like it, but kind of like when they disrespect comedians, like, oh, I can be a comedian too. Let me go do stand up one day.
And look what happened to Daphne.
First of all,
she bombed for 45 minutes straight.
But she still, her personality killed in the back room.
I know, but it's just funny.
It's funny though. He said it was such conviction. Like, hey, she bombed.
It's the fact that he kept bringing it up. He said it stunk.
He don't want you to forget.
But no, it's
actually
like
defended him too.
But it is. It's just like niggas try to use that as a way to get pussy, right?
Always.
So instead of just saying, like, you know what? As fucked up as it is, because I'm very clear in my bio on Twitter, I don't do meetups. I don't do random collabs. That is right there in my Twitter bio.
You know, where you see my link at.
But I have more respect for the niggas that DM me out of nowhere. They don't say, hey. They don't say, how you doing?
Hey, let's fuck.
They don't say, damn, man, I like that video with such and such. You know, can I? The very, very, very first message is, how much? That's all they say. How much? At least your intentions are clear. Like, look, man, I'm just trying to, I just want some pussy. I just want to buy it. How much is it? Rather than try to make it seem like you are a content creator in order to fuck bitches. You don't do no fucking content. Every time I see motherfucking tweets from you, you're talking about sports. Video games or some horny shit. Damn, man, I really want my dick sucked. Something like that. You ain't posted no promo. You ain't posted no link. You don't got no link in your bio.
If you're a content creator, you should never talk about you want your dick sucked. You call up your person. You, hey, let's make a video. You got your dick sucked and you got paid.
I don't know, Tom.
Niggas is weird, man.
I wasn't there.
Did you see what they said? You see what old boy said to Ashley in the bar? Niggas is weird this day and age.
Nah, I didn't see that.
Let me go locate it.
But it, like, it's just, it's nuts because I am not a fucking Roxy Reynolds, Pinky, none of those, okay? But at the same time, I still feel like motherfuckers really got the audacity to even reach out to me on that.
Right, because you a real nigga. You only do album shit and they be calling you for mixtapes and you don't fuck around. I feel you.
No, that was probably the best.
That's the best. I've ever heard. So I only do album shit, bro. You niggas in this dirty ass mixtape game. Mm-mm.
Right, because it's like, bro, y'all got these dark ass grainy videos in somebody fucking basement and shit on a fucking bed with no frame, fucking with the covers halfway off, shit all jumpy and dark.
You can't even turn one of your bedrooms into a small studio.
Come on, let's collab, let's work.
This is wild.
We should do something.
That is rape.
That is definitely
you should be able to press charges on that nigga.
Like, absolutely. That's and then, like I said, like, they don't be having a fucking following.
Right.
So
they local mixtape rappers. Don't nobody know these niggas.
It's like, and then you have a lot of people where they're like, they'll, you know, want to compare themselves because they say, oh, well, she didn't work with Kev, you know, Sir Pipe-A-Lot. I've had him on the show before. But like, bro, this nigga is in the five digit numbers of followers. Nigga, you have like 60. Okay. And most of them are pity follows because you followed them and you wrote them on a timeline and said, hey, follow back. Because they do that.
See? Mixtape rappers.
I got so many message requests like, follow back, ma. Can I get a follow back? Can I get a follow back? I don't want to see you niggas on my timeline. Oh. That is the beauty of Twitter. It doesn't have to be mutual. you want to follow me because you want to see, hey, man, I'm trying to see what them clips be like. I don't want to follow you because I don't give a fuck about your life. I don't care what you're talking about. I don't want to see you. You following me is a choice, just like me not following you back is a choice. It's not because I'm Hollywood. It's not because I feel like I'm too good for it. It's just there's nothing that you say that I want to see, that I care about.
Okay, so let me tell you a secret. You can't say that it's not that I'm too good and then explain to a motherfucker why this shit is beneath you.
But that's what you're supposed to do.
And a motherfucker can't know the answer to a question they don't ask.
You are a sick individual.
You make quality content and invest in yourself. They just trying to get in where they Wayne can't fit in. And that's the thing. And it's like I said, it's not a thing where they're legitimately trying to do content. Because if you were, you would be promoting yourself. You would be trying to get yourself out here. Like, you niggas is just random as fuck. And be like, hey, let's work. Like, one nigga wrote me today, and I'm like, dog, you don't even have a fucking link in your profile, nigga. Do you even do porn?
Right. Imagine how real rappers feel when a motherfucker just like, nobody knows you, and you just on Twitter talk about let's work. What are we working on? Work on what, bro?
Yeah, you don't get no response.
How about you work on your fucking craft so somebody can find you? Get the fuck out of my DM. I was like, what is wrong with you?
You sound angry, one.
Literally the definition. I don't know what I said. I had a hangnail. I had to cut it. Sorry.
Where did you pull a fucking nail clipper from? You know what?
It's on the key.
Yeah, I think we were back at the point where you was like, it's not that this is beneath me, and then you explain why it's beneath you. Like, he said, not that I'm bougie.
No,
it didn't explain why you don't fuck with
me. No. I said it's not because I'm Hollywood, because I don't. I'm not big-headed about it, but what I'm saying is
I'm not fucking with you.
Right, like you just some random ass niggas, bro. Like,
I don't fuck with you.
You are a sick
non-poor making ass niggas. I don't fuck with you.
You funny as hell.
Old lying ass, small dick having ass niggas. I don't fuck with you.
Oh God, that shit is hilarious.
Okay. And then,
die.
Bro, I sent y'all a picture of the nigga that wrote me, bro. And even y'all said he was creepy. Even y'all said that nigga was creepy.
He definitely don't ask.
Bro, look like a henchman.
Yeah, he take L.
Take orders from the Joker.
That's crazy.
He definitely look like he don't.
It's
ask.
Not Hollywood because I have collabs with local people. It's just those niggas are ridiculous.
He really don't ask girls to come home with him. They just end up there with no clothes on.
Yeah, not that this is beneath me.
That is. I mean, if you've seen the dude, you've seen the dude.
Bro, I said you was a little bit too into that song when you was singing it. You was feeling a little bit too much.
What was he singing?
I don't fuck with you.
Oh.
Because you know he always be like, I don't fuck with you. He said, hey, you belong, you're hard, this motherfucker.
I just be.
Nah, but it is like, I have content with local creators, but these are people that I have seen, okay? Like, it's like, all right, this nigga shit is actually legit. He has a nice following. It's cool. It ain't just like, y'all just want me to fuck on some dust bunny ass niggas for nothing.
Who wants you to know?
Right.
I barely
want you to fuck on the niggas you fuck on.
Nah, but I'm talking about them. Like, they just... You know, kind of.
They want you to put your best work on these mixtapes.
They trying to throw their hat in a ring that doesn't exist.
You the NBA.
Throw their name in a hat that doesn't exist.
I tell you, they want
you to lower your standards so they can be right. Like, well, you let Tone Bone, whatever the dude name on
Terry. The nigga Terry Bone. I know I look better than him. They want you to be. You the NBA and these niggas is the N1 street ball team.
If I like them niggas, this wouldn't be a conversation because I'd be fucking them. Okay.
She don't like them niggas, fam.
They just
when they become part of the group, the family group chat joke, bro. She don't like them niggas.
Bro, they like are so, like, bro, I sent y'all the picture. Y'all saw how creepy he was. That was the one that just wrote me talking about some DM me. I said, for what?
What?
Why? No.
Hey, I just want people to know that that is probably the dumbest shit I've seen y'all write on Facebook.
DM me.
Like, if we're here talking, for like 7 fucking comments, and then you just say DM. What, bitch, for what?
Sometimes there's some things you just can't say out loud.
Okay, well, don't announce that.
I feel what
you
saying.
I'm finna DM you. Just DM. But hey, bro, I'm about to hit you on your DM. No, just send a message. Just how I see this fucking comment pop up, I'm gonna see that goddamn bell notification.
Well, I think it'd be more so the fact that
you want my attention, you feel special.
You wanna know that it's coming or something?
They're right, like
re-download the app so you know I'm
not like
write
if
you.
They no, when they tell you like I'm about to DM you or whatever, so that you are expecting it and don't ignore it. So then they figure if they announce it first, you come like, oh bro, I didn't know or I didn't see it or whatever. Like I told you I was finna DM you, nigga. Why you ain't look for it? I think
it depends on who it's from.
But yeah, I just feel like, and those, like, why do I do OnlyFans? Yes, I enjoy fucking, but I do OnlyFans for money. That is my thing. Like, it is me doing something that I enjoy for financial gain.
Let me ask you a question.
And I feel like niggas right. are not trying to link because it's a money situation. Like, they just trying to link because it's like, ooh, content pussy. No, leave me alone.
You get paid to rap, and these niggas want you to kick a freestyle.
Dog, you was on it with the
are you
high?
I'm very high.
That is probably why you on point.
Okay. I said this on Twitter earlier, but I feel like when it comes to local niggas, they basically want me to be their porn guinea pig.
They want you to be the first stop.
They want to be your tester.
So just because we're in the same city, they feel like, oh well, we're from the same city, we should automatically link up. Like
that's not
how it works. Like I said, all they post is fucking sports and rap shit, and I'm horny type of tweets. Like no. But I do. I feel like when niggas are local and they feel entitled to work with you because you're from the same city, it's like, bro, you're not putting me on.
That's not how it
works. At all.
Right.
Like, at all. Like, I've told y'all before, like, fella has sent DMs to me, and I was like, I ain't really ready to deal with that yet.
And he kind of famous.
And he is on.
Right.
So if I didn't do that, I'm really not finna fuck with you.
Right. See, they want you to sign with AEW, and you're not going. I feel you.
AEW is not that bad. These niggas is more like...
And you see that talk? You see that right there? That's the nigga whole pitch. I don't want to do it. You'll enjoy it.
AEW. You let me finish, though.
You answer everything right there, bro.
AEW is not that bad. These niggas is more like Impact. You cut me
off. Whoa.
Now, see, that was ignoring
her. This is the most disrespectful shit you can actually say to me. Do say a fam, we ain't even got a tape. I don't fuck nobody
don't
for
fuck
recreation.
Tape, see, okay,
the one nigga that I fuck for recreation is gone because he's mad at me because I don't fuck nobody else for recreation.
He is gone. The nigga you fuck for recreation is mad because you
if
fucking
I'm not. If I'm not your bitch, don't ask to fuck me off of camera. See, that's how that works.
See, that right there is a prime example.
I am not bonus pussy for anybody.
The nigga asked for the verse, got the verse, didn't even put it nowhere. It ain't on the album. It ain't even on the mixtape. He just bought a verse.
You just sitting on the beat.
Man, like a motherfucker.
10 years sitting on the beat.
No, because I get that a lot where people want me to like come in and like, oh, well, we should get this threesome popping off, or we should do this, or we should do that. No, because that bitch doesn't want to be on camera. And I'm not fucking nobody if I can't record it because I'm not your bitch. There's no incentive for me to just fuck you because you want to fuck me. There's no incentive for me. So I have to have a monetary gain from a video in order for me to agree.
Okay, so
and even then, I still tell you niggas no because I don't want to touch y'all.
Real question. Is this really how these niggas talk? Like, okay, I get it. It's pussy. But it's business pussy. You niggas don't got like a three-step marketing plan? Another, like, y'all don't even try to sell yourself? Y'all just be like,
they don't.
Let me fuck.
Niggas don't. Like, niggas don't
man,
come with no records.
One dude told me I was mean because I told him that I don't do.
Each other.
I sent that to y'all in the group too.
I told you if you make it to the family group chat, you trash, fam.
Yeah. But he's like, oh, well, you know, we can link and smoke and, you know, do whatever and get you. And what did I do? I purposely dodged that. I was like, well, I'm doing better now. Thanks for asking, blah, 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 blah. And I totally just didn't address that. Then he come back like, well, you said that if we get to know each other, then it could happen. Bro, I've never said anything close to that. And the fact that niggas will just make up shit like that in their head, like, I okayed it and I clearly didn't. I didn't speak on it at all, but you're telling yourself that I okayed it. Y'all come up as rapey to me.
That name's a terrible
name. When I tell you no, leave it at fucking no. Don't try to convince me from that because I feel creeped out and I feel weird because I'm like, if you are not understanding no now, if I were to give you the pussy and decided, and this is not really where I want to be at, I don't like it, you would be the type of nigga that wouldn't stop. Don't I don't want y'all touching me.
Crack you in the back of your head with a frying pan.
Why is there a frying pan in the bedroom, bro?
These niggas is weird, fam.
That's lashed.
Yeah, this should be weird, man. Like, if I tell you that I don't want to work, I'm avoiding it, whatever, like, and leave it alone.
Have we not learned anything from Bill Cosby? Stop offering people drugs, fam. Like, you don't really know if everybody does drugs.
No, that's the crazy thing.
Stop offering drugs. That's illegal.
A lot of these niggas want to smoke and match to try to fuck. That's why so many are quick, hey, let's match. And as soon as y'all match, they trying to fuck right away.
And I've said on Facebook before that I didn't even get the point of matching. Because if we're matching, ain't it the same amount of weed anyway?
It should be.
Like if I say, all right, well, match. That means your amount of weed is supposed to match my amount of weed. But if it's two of us and we have the same amounts of weed and we're just dividing it by two, it's the same amount of weed. So how about I just say, hey, Juan, I'm finna come over and we could just smoke in each other's face? Because it's not really matching, is it?
See, in actuality, it's supposed to be blunt, got light.
There's a concept behind it that I understand, but...
When you say it like that?
Yeah, because I mean, like, when I say it's like, well...
Oh, trust me, I know they are.
I'll bring a blunt, and then you'll bring a blunt, and then we'll pick a blunt to smoke. And if we make it to the second blunt... Then we smoked each other's blunt. But it's an even exchange. It's not that you smoking all my fucking weed type of deal.
No, sometimes it's you smoking all my weed.
That's what I'm saying. Like you said, it's an even exchange. But if it's an even exchange, what are we really exchanging?
I don't know. That's just I don't know.
Cause okay.
I don't
know much about weed. But what I'll say is, okay, how much is an ideal amount of weed?
I like a 3-5.
Okay. I got a 3-5.
Right.
You got a 3-5.
Right.
Now, my math, 3-5 plus 3-5 equals 7. That's just how we go do this.
Right. So we got a whole 7.
So we got a 7. Now.
All right.
We are matching. We are bringing my 3-5 and your 3-5 to make 7.
Right.
I smoke 3-5. You smoke 3-5 because we matched. Why the fuck didn't we just smoke our own shit to begin with? It's the same amount of weed.
It's because niggas want to get
ready. I showed up with 3-5. You showed up with 3-5. We said, hey, let's power range this shit and put it together and build a motherfucking robot. But then when we split the robot, we got the same shit that we walked in the door with.
That's not how it goes. That's not how it goes.
So then it's not matching.
No, what
somebody's getting over.
No, like it's
the nigga who's trying to write.
If I bring a blunt and then Tone bring a blunt. So now we have two blunts.
Two blunts for two people.
But we do not smoke both blunts at the same time. Like, I don't like mine and he don't like his. It's one blunt.
Right. But what I'm saying
then is... Then we get to the second blunt later.
If there's a later.
Right.
So what...
But if there's not a later, then somebody got over it, like I said.
Yeah, if you look at it like that, because I might not take it home with me. I may leave it with you. So then you had all the weed. So you end up with the whole 7.
So, but the point what I was making is they come over with that one blunt, even though you got a blunt.
Right.
They smoke that first blunt. Now, all of a sudden, the niggas all horned up and trying to get some ass.
Now, you got to know who you're dealing with when you do stuff like that.
They be doing it with anybody.
Like you can't do that with anybody.
They be trying to do it with every chick they know.
I mean, it's different. It's like, all right, I got buffalo wings. You got taco dip. And Tone got liquor. Okay. We all sound contribute like a party. Different things.
Oh, so if right? I bring weed and you bring weed, it's not contributing?
It,
no, what I'm saying is...
I feel you, though.
It doesn't seem equally yoked.
Like, especially now, yeah.
Like
especially,
if you
what if my weed is stronger than your weed?
If you bring weed, you bring weed, and I bring liquor, is it really a party?
I mean, for us, this is different. We're family.
True. That don't count.
No, like if it's
my weed might be stronger than her weed.
Or her weed might be stronger than yours.
Right.
You don't want that.
It's just, I guess it's just the match word that gets me.
I feel
because to
that.
Me, match sounds like y'all are bringing equal parts.
Or and something that goes with something. Parts,
then it's, you know what I mean?
Right. Like if he's a less match, okay, I got the weed, you bring me a blunt, and now we got bring two things that match.
Yeah, bring the bong. Now we, that's why I said it really should be got blunt, got fire.
Because like, right. If like I said, if I show up with buffalo wings,
that's why I just say, let's have a
you
session.
Show up
makes sense.
With taco dip and you bring alcohol, but I eat all the buffalo wings, you eat all the taco dip, you drink all the alcohol. We just basically took all of our shit and just ate it in the same room together.
It just made me an
it
alcoholic.
Wasn't really a match. Because we ended up with what we fucking bought.
Right. That's why they should just say, hey, let's have a session.
Sessions make sense.
Session makes sense. Match doesn't. In my opinion, just how it
sounds. I don't even know what nigga came up with that.
Yeah,
it's just a thing.
I feel like the nigga that came up with it was short.
Is raping people
and wanted to sample everybody else's shit, and that's where match came.
Scavenger.
That's probably
a scavenger.
Like, damn man, I ain't got enough to fill this month. Hey, bro, let's match.
And
then you
like
your
sense.
Shit first.
You got a little so bit of weed.
And no, then y'all no. Get too high. And then he still get to keep his little smidgen
no,
of weed.
No, that makes
had.
Sense. Because if you got a little bit of weed and you got a little bit of weed, we can at least get a good blunt out of here.
So you can feel the blunt then.
Yeah.
Even though only both of y'all had half the amount of weed.
And,
so you're both only smoking half of the weed. But at least you could fit into one blunt.
And get a good high.
And then.
In that way, if somebody passes out, there's somebody that's still woke that can at least make sure a nigga get out of my house.
Homegirls that are content creators, a lot of niggas we wouldn't think be offering to buy pussy. Yeah, look. A lot of niggas y'all wouldn't think, okay? I know the niggas that's out here offering to buy pussy because a lot of them be offering to buy mine.
I'm just not going to put nothing past nobody.
You can't this day.
I don't judge people for buying pussy, though.
You can't.
I don't judge people for
some
buying
people
pussy.
Don't want to deal with the look, whole entire rigmarole.
You
want to
know why I don't sell mine? Because I don't know how to price it. I don't know how to price pussy. And I know that my shit ain't trash, but then I don't want to undersell myself. So that's why I don't sell pussy. It's not because I'm above it and it's, oh my God, I would never do that. I have morals. No, it's because I don't know how to price it.
Dog, I'm so mad. She said, I don't know what the fair market value of pussy is.
If there was a Kelly Blue, if there was a Kelly Blue book for pricing pussy and I had it, then I would probably sell it. I don't know what to put the price on it as
hey,
because
kid,
I feel like you can't afford it.
That's a good. I get it though. Like,
that's why I don't sell pussy because I don't know what to sell it for. And I feel like I never want to go too low.
It's like it's
$40 ain't enough. $100 ain't enough. $200 ain't enough. I know I can do some shit, and I'm not gonna just sell myself short. That's why I don't sell pussy.
Is it a buyer's market or a seller's market?
Pussy? It's definitely a buyer's market.
No, I'm not a smoker. I do edibles. If two I'm around.
You must be talking about Jamal. You said two of y'all.
No, we are the ones questioning the matching thing. So
you're just questioning the word. I still do it.
Yeah.
But I only match with certain niggas. Like if Juan say, hey, Tone, come through, let's match. Yeah, but we don't talk like that. Me and Juan.
There is
like,
definitely a value scale. Yeah, because it's like, and I be looking like, you really? Because I see a lot of, you know, I'm on Twitter. I advertise my OnlyFans on Twitter. So there are a lot of content creators, women who will be like, hey, I'm doing meetups today, $100, or I'm doing collabs today, $100. And I'm like, $100? Eh.
Sound too
ain't finna be no random niggas fucking me for $100. Dang. I feel like, remember when Smokey got that money from his mama? This ain't even enough. That's me. Okay. I might not know how much it should cost, but I know how much it don't.
It reminds me of that conversation they was having on the episode of the 85 South Show.
Okay, so you ain't never smoked with a chick you was finna fuck. Smoking with somebody you already know that you finna fuck versus just doing it because you like, all right, I think this will increase my chances. That's something totally different.
Honestly, I would only fuck a chick if we fucked before we ever smoked.
Vegas hoes start at $300. See?
I just
is that because the cost of living higher?
Vegas holes, period.
I just want y'all to know that niggas only do shit because somewhere in life somebody said yes.
Man, big facts. So we been said.
Like, what I've said, I'm like, look, I don't know who that works on, but it doesn't work on me.
So, like, somebody said yes to this.
We
shit.
Said that when random niggas dive in inboxes and say, "Let me eat your pussy," they only do it because some chick has said sure.
But why would you want to eat random Facebook pussy?
Look, bro, I don't know why these niggas do what they do. They built different now.
Why do you want to smoke with random Facebook hoes?
And then it's like, I can't ask the bitch, hey, why do you price your pussy like that? Because they might get offended. But I really want to know, like, what made you value your pussy at $100? To say, no, just to say, like, all right, I'm going to give it to you, but you got to give me $100 in exchange.
Maybe it's fair market value.
That's what I'm saying.
Do
like,
you know the risk behind that $100?
We need a Kelly Blue Book.
I'm just guessing. Maybe you it's don't know. Maybe because that's the going right across the board.
Because this is my thing. Like, it's not like it's other content creators. Like, it be like meetups and shit. And at least with us, with other content creators, like with the community of us,
it's a safe space.
Right. Like, I can go and say, all right, well, he was just tested. She was just you know what I'm saying? Like,
you got proof.
You can't do that with random motherfuckers. Right, they just right. show up with their dick in the hand like Mystical.
Yeah, you see what that guy
you see? I was like, you see where he's been twice.
Yeah, he's out now, though.
Yeah, he'll be back in a couple of months.
No, bro, I hope you stop. You got to stop raping. Like, why they keep letting this nigga out on the street?
your homie fucking with you, like, bro, you gotta stop raping, dog. Now, you gotta be around to see your kids grow up, dog. You gotta stop raping. Said
you gotta stop raping. What the fuck, dog?
You said it.
But then it's like, okay, when you price pussy, do you put like an actual numerical value on it, or do you say, well, you know what, if he pays my mortgage, I would fuck him.
I think that's a good way to look at it. Because some women have their price. And I think the price that you have varies on the situation that you are in.
It does based on your situation.
Because it's like, you might say, like, I ain't fucking no nigga for $100. But then if you're like, all right, I'll pay your phone bill, but your phone bill $125.
Right. So I think the price varies depending on your situation and why you are selling it on this day.
On this day.
Right. I'm just saying that's real shit.
Or they can think it the logical, like, if
like she just said, I would never sell my pussy for $100. Then you'd be like, damn, I kind of need my phone bill paid. So I know what I got to do to get this phone bill paid.
Or they can look.
So you're right. It's not $100.
Yeah, I can call a dude and tell him Jelly Beanie her phone bill paid. They just get the money from him.
Well, you might look at it like this. They may look at how the value of a day is worth.
It's all a hustle. Some people bought my weed for 40
niggas in one day.
A 3-5. Some people got charged 50.
In an 18-hour day at $100 each, you just made $800. You made more than some people.
You set your price unless you got a pimp setting your prices. Well, I know that. What I'm saying is, how do you come up with what you're going to charge?
What do you need today?
You can't but no, they be consistent. The price.
Because that $40 joke can't. Didn't come out of nowhere.
Like, why would you charge? Okay, today I'm charging $100. Tomorrow I'm charging $150. And there's no rhyme or reason why you went up $50.
I just said, what did you need today?
Then that's what you do between you and your permanent, I guess.
No, like, if you are, in my opinion, if I'm going to sell shit, if Juan is out here selling dick, slanging wood, I'm gonna wake up okay, and I'm gonna see what the fuck is on the docket of what we need today.
Okay, perfect example, like with OnlyFans, like with me pricing my OnlyFans. Remember, I ended up increasing
right.
my OnlyFans price, the access price.
Your well, initially, was greater than what other people. Your
initially, when my subscription price was lower, I was charging for each video that I was putting out.
Right.
With me raising my prices, because I know that cheap niggas don't like to pay, even though it's still less than $20 a month, that helped me weed out those type of niggas while still being able to reward the people that were subscribed. Because it's like, now you're paying this higher price a month, but I'm not whacking y'all for every single video that I do.
Well, maybe that's where the $100 comes into play at. $100 is the base price, so you just get ass. But if you want mouth, anal, no condom, golden showers. You know,
and his menu is wild.
What you want, the price goes up.
Says, how much do you want to charge? You don't have to set a price. you might not even charge the same price to different niggas or bitches.
Boom.
What I'm saying is, regardless, how do you come up with a number regardless in your head to say, well, this is how much I want. This is how much I feel like my pussy is worth. Even if it's just today.
Well,
I just said you got to figure out what you need for the day.
Some chicks who jump out there already got a friend or two who's jumping out there. So maybe they're going based off of what their base prices are.
How about, let's look at it like this. What do you think your total expenses are for a day? Now, let's look at it like it's a Saturday. So, you know, at the end of this day, you got somewhere to be because you want to go out. So, you need to calculate between the time of getting ready and the time that you have to sell this ass, what all you need that goes into this day. Because you know you're going to want money to go out.
That ain't enough for me.
How many people are you fucking in one day? Like, what's it your don't
matter. I mean, maybe you're not just fucking multiple people. Maybe you just that one nigga that's willing to pay. You hit him with, this is the price.
That's different.
Well, the guy that I have that does that, I never even met him in real life.
So if you feel like you need $500 for the day, this is $500 pussy on a Saturday.
Or you can just ask this nigga for $500. You probably can get that without fucking if you got that one dude.
That's all I'm saying, Tyler. Don't matter how you got the $500.
You are down a completely different path than what Mimi was talking about, though.
How?
No, because it's shit
she
that
just
I...
just said, what's the price of your pussy?
It's shit that I need.
You are...
And there's shit that I want.
Right.
But I still feel like it's not like for me to just be like, hey, I'm about to charge you this specific amount for my cat. Like, it's just, I don't know.
Well, you don't sell pussy, so you don't have to worry about these kind of thoughts. That's but just she, like when niggas say, I don't get gay people.
Is,
you're not gay, so it ain't for you to get.
Her head, it's see, this be there till she get an answer.
These are times where I wish my granny was alive, because I'd have asked her how she priced her hoes pussy.
Let's go find a hoe on the street and have
like, granny, did you have a sunshine in your stable, like from Harlem Nights? Like, did you have one of those where she had niggas not want to go home no more? How much did you charge for her pussy?
It ain't over yet.
I told you, once she get a thought, she's not going to be done with it until she gets an answer.
Well, we don't got this.
Because it's just baffling. Because like I said, I don't judge people for selling pussy. I don't judge people for buying it. I just want to know what the pie chart says, okay?
The pie chart.
Hey, well, I think prices fluctuate because maybe niggas will be like, hey, we not willing to pay this price no more.
Does prices change based on the time of the day? Like, is there a prime time rate?
It could be a happy hour.
Is there a week?
If you catch me between 5 and 7, you could get it for the 150.
A happy hour.
After that is 550. It's going back up to 550.
Is there a lunch special?
I don't know.
Okay, you can't say, but that's exactly how you come up with the price. But then, with $300 is the base rate. Like, if you have a base rate, then it's not based off of your expenses for the day. Then, is it? What he is saying.
If you got
totally different things.
If you got a base rate, you definitely come with a menu.
That's what I'm saying. That's when you go back to what I say. The base is $100, just like you want to weed out niggas.
Well, okay.
You
know what?
And then you what they want.
They don't be having a base rate though. Now that I could probably see, like, all right, well, I get a base rate of whatever. But nigga, if you want some extra shit, then
there's gotta be a base rate.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if you want some appetizers and dessert and all of that shit, then you're gonna.
I have never bought an ass, but I do get hit with these inboxes.
Did you say bought an ass? You've never bought an ass?
Yeah, never bought an ass. Never bought it.
You want a water dog?
Yes. I hate y'all.
You said, fam, look, just don't sell no pussy. You too difficult. I'm not difficult.
Hey, but yeah, but when they hit you with the base rate, they definitely come with a menu. So it's like base rate is $100, or they hit you with the timesheet. Like some chicks be like, okay, for 30 minutes, it's $75. But then it's like for 60 minutes, it's, you know, this price. And then you pay depending on.
Sure.
You pay depending on how many hours you want for this bitch.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
Yeah, see, you would just have to get you a menu.
Thanks, bro.
Yeah, get you a menu. And then just like, you know, filet mignon Dinkins or some shit. I don't know.
Who said button?
The one said.
Did he?
Yeah.
No, he said.
I feel
said,
like I, yours is cold.
No, he didn't say I like never that. Bought an ass. Like button as the word. He said I never bought an ass. Like,
right.
like an individual ass he's like, never purchased.
Yeah, never bought one ass. Now two, that's a different story. Different number.
Could you handle two?
No, sir, I'm not buying anything I can't handle.
At least you're honest.
That's crazy.
Yeah, see, that's niggas are not honest.
So, Mimi, why are we here today?
That's crazy.
Have a base topic.
Yeah, what's the basis of this shit today?
Oh, we done talking about me trying to figure out how to sell ass.
We realized. Either you're going to have a menu or you just going to have a fluctuating scale like an arm loan.
We got add-ons and shit. Drop down menu.
You come with DLC.
Downloadable content, bro.
Yeah, she has an OnlyFans by definition.
Say yeah. So you know.
Well,
yeah.
One of the hot topics today is Lakia.
Somebody explain to me what the fuck happened.
Did she really work at 76? Because I ain't never seen her in there.
I could have. I don't know.
Blew my mind. I was like,
if she did, when? Because all we know is a little bit.
Well, she said when she was 16, which would have been 4 years ago. I bought the house 7 years ago. So
we ain't never seen her unless she popped in for a couple of days and quit.
No, we could have. But even so, it's like, to bring that up now.
She didn't work no weekend.
It's irrelevant. Because it's like, oh, well, you was working on 76. Well, guess what? Now she's in the room with Nicki Minaj and everybody else taking pictures and shit while you were on Facebook in that little tight-ass Green Bay shirt.
So y'all gonna sit here and act like Fabulous didn't have a job at McDonald's before he blew up?
No, but when really?
I didn't know that.
I'm just saying, like, in general, niggas had real jobs. The fuck?
Bro know me so well. He said, fam, you're not selling no pussy. You go tell the motherfucker paying you're not attracted to him. That is so true. That is so true. Because paying or not, bro, if I'm not attracted to you, it's gonna be like, yeah, your money's
it's good only here. Really one beat nigga it peasant. It's only one nigga she really attracted to.
Beat it, peasant.
Is that what you tell them? This is a non-refundable policy.
All sales are final.
Your money's no good here. No,
you won't even take the money
before you even slide you the cash. Like, nah, keep it.
We cool, bro. Enjoy love.
Now, basically what happened was she was doing an interview. It was like a 30-minute YouTube video.
Okay.
And they were asking her things, you know, as far as like with the music and growing up Milwaukee, things like that. Now, as you know, niggas do.
What niggas do?
Snippets. Okay. So they took a snippet of this, probably like 30 seconds out of a 30-minute video, where she was saying how there were only two things that you could really do here. And that was be CNA and do lashes, and she wasn't trying to do that, so she got the fuck out of Dodge.
Ah, so now Rudy's thing makes sense. Gotcha.
Dog, that shit had me in terror.
So, she, now prior to that, the interviewer asked her, like, you know, when did you know that, you know, you needed to get out of Milwaukee? And she said, like, right after she graduated high school.
Okay.
She said that she got accepted into, like, crazy colleges and shit, like HBCUs and even some nice colleges here. But she didn't want to do that shit. And then she went on into the, you know, the CNA and Lash Tech and whatever, and she didn't want to do that. So that's when she got the fuck out of Dodge. Now, everybody is in an uproar about this. What kills me about this is, you niggas have clowned CNAs from top to bottom from the very fucking beginning. And I know this because I speak on it all the time about how they don't get the fucking respect that they should.
They really don't.
Because all you niggas do is make fucking CNA jokes. Whenever you see a motherfucking Scrubs, bitch, you ain't no nurse, you a CNA. You work at a daycare. But now all of a sudden, everybody is so upset and angry because of what the fuck she said.
Okay, I'm gonna have a stupid moment for a second. What the fuck does CNA even stand for?
Certified Nursing Assistant.
Oh, okay. Well, she halfway a nurse.
So they do all the dirty work that the nurses don't do. All
right, like, she almost there. A couple more classes, you'll get there.
No, it's more than a couple more classes, fam.
Look, Tone, I was trying to give motherfuckers hope.
Whole another $50,000. Bruh, I still got student loans that I'm helping my wife pay back, bruh.
But she a nurse.
She's a CNA. So I got to stand on her with that. But she loved being a CNA, though. She damn near want to go back to it. she loved to work, but want to keep the check. But I always wonder, like, what was going on these past few days that everybody was going crazy over?
Right, bro says she tweeted, "Why y'all mad like CNAs and nail techs?" She didn't even say nail techs though. She said lash techs on the video. Everybody keeps saying nail techs. I don't know where nail came from.
Usually both.
Don't get a bag, motherfucker. Still popping shit. But
it's the fact, bro. Like, let's Milwaukee keep it been a buck. Hating.
Been waiting to hate on her since she got on.
Let's keep it a buck though. There was a moment in time everybody was being a CNA because it was the only real.
I am the only one that wasn't doing CNA. Or daycare work.
Right.
And I have never shit on either.
And you did. It was
I don't like other people's kids.
You really don't.
And I'm very squeamish. So cleaning shit and throw up and all of that kind of stuff, I couldn't handle it. I didn't do it not because I looked down on it. It's just those two things weren't for fucking me. Even though all of my cousins did that shit. At some point, all of them have done CNA or daycare work. My sister's a fucking CNA right now.
There's nothing wrong with being a CNA. It was a highly sought after job at one point in time.
I was reading the internet.
Because it was easy to get into, and clearly they don't drug test you motherfuckers. Because every CNA and daycare worker that I know damn near smokes a shit ton of weed. So you motherfuckers can take care of elderly people and other motherfuckers' kids and smoke weed all goddamn day. But I got to get drug tested to push some motherfucking papers and push some buttons on the keyboard.
Yeah, pretty much.
My phone. Yeah.
Most of that shit. I'll be a CNA if I need to. Unlimited OT for the 3 months they gonna have me make it work.
Always unlimited OT with CNAs, fam.
Right. But honestly, I feel like sometimes people that are CNAs can be a little bit offended.
Just
because, like, even when you mention it, and they should be on the defensive because, like I said, they're always being attacked. But even with my cousin, me and her still beefing to this day, and I feel like it's because she's felt some type of way ever since I made that post years ago when I was asking why they don't get paid more. Not because I was knocking CNAs, but because I genuinely don't understand why motherfuckers who sit in the office all goddamn day barely doing anything made double digits in pay, while a lot of CNAs, they wasn't even starting them off at fucking $10 an hour with all of the shit that they was doing. And CNA. I felt that was unfair. But she too fucking slow and retarded to know what the fuck I was saying.
Wow. CNAs didn't get respect until literally COVID.
They still don't. I just saw a fucking CNA meme the other day. So I guess that's what kills me. Like, y'all look for any type of reason, and the biggest thing is y'all be motherfucking hypocrites. Like, y'all are the same people. Oh, she just needs to be humble. She ain't even got a second album yet. You have none.
Oh.
And you know what else I didn't
get? You have none.
I was like,
this motherfucker is bumping shoulders with fucking celebrities that you be masturbating to.
With Cannon.
Yes.
Oh, she got a Cannon mixtape, right, fam. Right. Y'all ain't
DJ Drama, nigga, is a gangster grill.
Like, y'all be, Moneybagg, Nicki Minaj, y'all are standing over motherfuckers that she's elbow to elbow with in the same fucking room. But now, she need to be humble. You are the same bitches who are always on motherfucking Facebook talking about a broke bitch could never, period. But now you talking about somebody need to be fucking humble. Hey, you hoes don't sit the fuck down somewhere.
I bet all them hoes who say she need to be humble way past 30.
Nah, they still be young, dumb.
Nah, and way past 30.
Young,
man.
Dumb, and full of somebody else.
You gotta think about it, bro. She don't even think she's 21 yet.
Oh, fam, she's good.
Hey, CNA checks be fat as a bitch too. Matter of fact, she'll be looking for us to see, because they work all them doubles and shit. Fam. If it's one thing about a CNA, them bitches work hard.
They do.
Fam. They work hard. They will spend all their motherfucking time at work. Bitch, I can't go to the club tonight. I'm busting doubles all weekend. All right, man. Get that shit.
It was one year.
You need to know those. Let me know.
It was 1 year. I bullshit you not, and I didn't believe me. She didn't show her pay stub. Teresa hit 6 figs as a CNA. That was also the year that I was like, I'm too good for you bitches. I'm married a white.
Y'all niggas killing me. Like, bro, y'all 35 and up. She not even 20.
Y'all just mad because y'all 20. Rap careers.
So, look at her lifespan of what the fuck she's seen compared to a 35 almost.
Right.
Right. And y'all mad at what she said? Bitch, that's all these hoes do. They want to be CNA or they want to do hair and nails. So she was like, I ain't doing neither.
That's not
so
what, all, that's not for her.
Right.
So, because all of those years ago, because if I made a statement similar to hers based off of when I was her age, I would have said the same thing about CNA and fucking daycare, because that's what everybody was doing. Right. When I was coming up and I was a teenager, everybody was doing CNA work or fucking working in daycares. Everybody was in the home child care center. That's what they were doing. And what did I say? That wasn't for me, because I don't like other people's kids. I don't want to work somewhere and I can't punch your kid in the face because they be doing dumb shit.
Do you say punch your
kid? It's like motherfucking.
Because they be out of order, bro. They be doing little shit like purposely spitting on you and kicking you in the fucking shins and shit because they know you can't beat their motherfucking ass. Fuck these kids.
It's like a motherfucker looking at this surroundings.
So based on your life and where you were, like only in the past couple years, now all of a sudden you see everybody is doing their own shit. Everybody's popping out with boutiques and everything else. And that's another fucking thing. You are the same motherfuckers who are always complaining about everybody doing the same thing. Now all of a sudden everybody want to sell bundles and hair. Now all of a sudden everybody want to do nails. Now everybody want to do lashes. But now you're mad because somebody said, oh, but these were the only two options for me to really do. But y'all are the same motherfuckers that's always bitching that somebody is copying somebody else because they chose to do something that somebody you know is already doing. Something that you're already doing. What the fuck are you talking about? That's like me. I sell dicks and shit. It was motherfuckers that was selling dicks and shit in the city before me. It might not have been a lot of them, but it was other motherfuckers doing it. So what? If that's what the fuck I wanted to do and that's what was a calling to me and that's what I felt like doing, that's what I chose to do. If other motherfuckers get to doing dicks and shit, can I be mad? No.
You know what?
It is what it is.
I don't think people in the world understand that you need more than one person to do the same shit.
Like she's a fucking rapper. Okay. Before y'all was pissed off today and everybody was hanging off her little, you know, little titties and shit. She's a rapper. Y'all wasn't saying, but why she want to be a rapper? We got rappers already.
Right.
Everybody like, was, oh man, she a vibe. Hey, go
Mill Town. Can you imagine if it's only one fucking store? Because, oh no, can't none of you niggas open a store because I got a store. You know how fucking hectic your life would be if you was just one of you and you got to service every fucking body.
So, temptation.
The only thing I got mad about was the motherfucker copying and pasting my business policies and shit. I don't give a fuck about y'all selling toys and shit, but damn, don't go on my page and copy and paste all my shit.
Edit the business.
One thing about me is I'm very detailed in my shit. I put a lot of thought into the shit that I do. So, for you to just go and plagiarize my shit like that was something totally different. I don't give a fuck if you sell the same products I do. Just don't be going and copying and pasting my policies and shit. That was crossing the line. But you're not going to be the only person doing something. That's not how it goes. So when you know that you are not going to be the only person doing something, you work your ass off to try to be the best person doing that thing. It's that simple.
Big facts.
Niggas is
what I said was it remind me of that episode of The Game with Malik when he was getting interviewed, and that nigga was like, "You're either slinging crack rock or you got a wicked jump shot." But in my case, a wicked jump shot is
a 50-yard bomb down the sideline.
Except,
hey, he wasn't lying though.
Hey, but why Michael Eric Dyson go in like that on his dog? Yeah, so I hope she don't go punching a handicapped nigga in the wheelchair like he did, but that's all just remind me of. Like, everybody wants something to be angry about. And most of the people that are angry, it either just kind of went over their head to be like, damn, you know, this is her age. This is probably what she was around. Well, that's your fault that you wasn't around other people.
You don't know what was going on in their life.
I don't understand, niggas. Like, bro, she's 20. What could she have really seen between social media now and 20 fucking years ago?
Social media just need to go away forever.
No, certain people should just stop using Facebook.
Nah, man. Let that app can go. It done ran its course.
Well, what other app we gonna have,
Tom? Just make a new one like they always did.
And it's gonna end up like Tom on MySpace.
Tom was a cool dude.
Kayla says, and the city isn't the same as it was when we were late teens, early 20s. Very, 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 very
right. Cool. I know
it's a bunch just of like Compton.
And you good with work? Yeah, that's why I take pride in my shit, man.
She's a wordsmith.
Yeah, I am.
She wordy.
I'm a surgeon with this shit.
Surgical.
Man, niggas steal my sauce every week, and motherfuckers know it's my drip style, so I just keep leveling up on their bitch ass. Yeah, I'm just.
You know.
You should already know.
No, I know who it is. I just had. had a question. I'm gonna let it go.
Yeah, but I just feel like a lot of the people that are blowing it out of the water are demographic. It's a demographic that shouldn't even give a fuck. Like I have my own business. Okay. I have my own business. I didn't get offended and say, well, that's not true. I started a sex toy business. I'm offended. That's what that girl knows. Maybe it's because with me seeing it with my own eyes and knowing like the options and shit, like in her age group, maybe that's really what she fucking felt like. Like, I have to do this. And you are the same niggas that are always complaining about motherfuckers only support you if you popular anyway. All the time. They don't support talent here in Milwaukee. They only support popularity. Y'all find something to complain about all the time.
Definitely she got talent, because I'm telling you like this, I didn't know who the hell she was for that album dropped.
And they said, cool whip.
Wait, why I hate these niggas so much, dog.
It's him.
Why you put so much emphasis on that?
Like, very, very terrible.
Wait.
Hey, so in like weird news, y'all know who Gaston is from Beauty and the Beast, right?
Gaston.
Yeah.
Okay.
This big buff nigga that was trying to fuck Belle, and she was like, no, I want this hairy nigga. And then he got in his chest and got the village to try to kill him.
Yeah. That's like,
you know what's crazy?
Is that not the plot of Beauty and the Beast?
That basically is, fam.
All these intricate ass stories be having the most simplest plot.
I was an hour and a half to say some shit.
I was trying to fuck your bitch. You wasn't going. So we're gonna get this hairy nigga out of here.
Hey, dog. A lot of Disney plots were very fucking rapey, fam.
Say it's true though. Popularity definitely trumps talent in the city, though. I'm not saying that that's not the case. What I'm saying is the same people that are sitting here and bitching and complaining about what she said. Even if you do start another motherfucking business, because it's more than two things to do in this city. All I gotta do is bitch about nobody supports you because you're not popular and don't nobody know your ass.
You gotta redirect your marketing, fam. If you feel like the city ain't support you, target the world.
Most of my customers are not from fucking Milwaukee. They're on the West Coast.
Big facts.
They're in Cali and Texas, and guess what? Those are big ass states. So I'm okay.
More niggas in Germany own unapologetic shirts than in the city.
It's perfectly fine.
And I'm cool with that.
But no, so it's one of like the Disney parks. You know, when you go to those places, they have like the live action.
Yeah.
They got the people.
Niggas in costumes. Characters.
Yeah. So.
Weird story before you go deep. Fun fact. My current trainer for my new job used to be Minnie Mouse at the Disney parks for like 10 years.
10 years?
10 years.
She's definitely a sociopath.
I agree with you because training be a little bit too happy.
Oh gosh, she ready to kill a nigga.
But to
now you know how we feel about you.
You think I'm ready to take a nigga out?
Just with that one moment. I'm gonna be burying niggas by that big ass cross.
I'm not driving no dead body to Kentucky. In the middle of
most
nowhere.
Most of my clients from out west too, but we was talking about hating ass Milwaukee. No, Tone brought up something. I'm like, shit, most of my motherfuckers not here either. Right. But anyway, so, you know, we got this guy in the Gaston costume at the little Disney park. And a white lady walks up. You know, they take pictures with people.
Right.
So she puts her hands on his, you know, like if as if their titties and like kind of squeeze a little bit, like she's going to take a picture with him. And he kicks her out like he's throwing her. What, like, you need
that's harassment, you know, Don't
it's so funny because I need somebody to remix this video because it reminds me of you need to leave, you know, that video that I always play. But she's standing here giggling and laughing and shit while he's telling her to go, so it's like she's not taking dog serious. Like, she tried to touch me, he like, no, like, you need to go. So she's like, all right, and eventually walk off, you know, she white, but. You can hear him at the end, like right when the video was cutting off. It's like, there are children. And then it stopped. But watching this video was real uncomfortable and disturbing because it's like, that's how women feel. And she really felt like she didn't do nothing wrong. Like, you walk up to this man and you really just put your hands on him with no consent whatsoever. And then when he's telling you, like, it's not cool, it's not okay, like, you think that he playing any joking and shit and try to do it again.
Right, but.
But had that been reversed, and that was somebody playing Cinderella or some shit.
He be doing 5 to 8.
And he get canceled.
And he went up and, hey, let me touch them Disney titties before we take this picture and shit.
Disney
Dog would have been arrested.
They's gonna beat his ass in that park.
No, but it was the fact that I don't know how to braid. I do not braid. That is not my thing.
Whatever Minnie Mouse they got
my
working
hair ain't braided under here.
Whatever Minnie Mouse they got working at Disney be throwing hands.
She washed her hair and came to record.
No, my wig on.
She's letting her cape flourish.
I'm laying my lace. I was supposed to get some do-up today, but he just texted me and said that his son just got dropped off.
Oh, damn.
I was trying to do some content. That's fine with me because now I can go home and eat. All I had today was a salad because I'm like, I didn't want to be bloated. And then, you know, when it,
y'all, you had one of them
salads. You got your legs pushed back and then it can, you get gas. Now I can go home and eat.
You got one of them
farting and queefing simultaneously.
I queefed so much in my last video. It's so funny.
See, Tom, why you always got to do that, bro?
Who knows what's coming out this damn heifer's mouth?
But you said queef.
He like that shit, though. He can turn on about that. Like, yeah, talk to me. Let me know I'm hitting that shit right. But it just be so funny to me because I'm childish. So queefs are fucking funny to me.
Queefs are saying the
queefs
word.
Queefs are hilarious, bro. Like, especially because, okay, to my female listeners. Now, males not going to understand. They know what they hear, but you know what it feels like. When your pussy is queefing, and if you childish like me and you laugh or cough or whatever, and it makes it more, and it's so like as you laughing, and it'd be like a rhythm to the queefing shit. I hate that.
You're dropping a mean
because it's childish, so I already laugh, and then it's making me do it more, which is making me laugh harder. So now it's really coming out. So yeah, that's always funny. What?
I hate you.
Why?
Yeah.
But yes, white women, stop going and thinking that you can just go and put your hands on Disney characters because they are males.
Right,
that is still touching people without their consent. And like the way she really, like, look, like she really grew up.
Sexual harassment.
That's a sexual assault in fourth degree.
Like, look. Hey, he and immediately he was getting.
Oh, God, he got it right out of there.
But she think he playing and still trying to touch him and shit.
Hey, if he'd have backhanded her, he'd have been A-okay.
Been all right.
There are children. But yeah, y'all got to relax with that shit.
Right. Just, you know. Now, what if he walked in your job and just decided to palm your ass while you was, you know, flipping a number two? On
right.
The
then it'd have been a whole Me Too thing. So, has everybody here watched Dave Chappelle yet?
Of course I have.
I finally caught up. Did you watch it yet?
I watched it twice, remember that?
I've been so slipping on TV, but I finally watched it. And I laugh
for the whole thing,
bro. The shit you be talking about, I can't believe these niggas talking shit about what I said to you. That's different because they can't control what comes out of my mouth. With y'all talking about sexual shit with me, it just makes them real uncomfortable.
Thank you.
I'm glad you put that in
right
way, because that's really what it
is. Really all it really is.
And niggas really don't care.
Yeah. Like with me, they literally have nothing over that. But for y'all, it's like, come on, bro. You see me sitting right here. You right. See what we got to go through. Why would you add on to that? I get it.
Niggas.
See, I got y'all back.
I feel it. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate Thank you very much.
Even though I can't lay on mine tonight, but whatever.
You know what? I'm going home.
Bazinga.
I'm going home.
Technically, Tone can by not putting it on the screen, but I'm working the comments.
Like, you got the comments. That way you control what niggas see and don't see. Plus, you can always see it before it hits the screen anyway, so you're prepared.
Yeah.
Dave Chappelle.
Yeah.
Greatest to ever do it.
But there are all, like, every time he does a special, he's supposed to get canceled. Nobody ever does it.
You can't cancel Dave Chappelle. Can't
cancel greatness.
Can't cancel him.
But he said it. He's like, look. It's never been trans people that I had a beef with. If you ever listen to my shit, it's always been white people. I laugh so hard because I'm like,
this is fun. Darn, that's true. Funny as a bitch.
So true. He's a, if you listen, he's a very big supporter of the LGBT.
I don't care about them niggas. You don't care about me sitting here because I told you to quit it and you don't do it. And you don't listen to me either, shit.
I just want you to know, bro. That's kind of rude, fam.
It's rude.
How you not care about the niggas that gotta sit and listen to this?
Correct.
How would you feel if I say, you know what, bro? Nah, come on, fam.
123 episodes we've had to deal with this shit. Actually, 130 because there's bonus episodes.
Hey, man.
We haven't done one in a while. I think I might need one.
I thought the last rerun was gonna be one, but I think you actually made it an episode.
Three episodes usually not bonuses.
No, I think you did make them. The first one you did.
So we won't ever make content, bro.
Yeah, you might have to go Arn Anderson on them and get the Glock.
I'm like, I mean, this takes me back to the beginning of the show. When I say no, just leave it at no. Don't try to convince me on why I need to give you some pussy. Because I've already... And okay, this is what kills me about niggas, right? Niggas will always say, well, women know if they want to sleep with you within the first blah, 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 right? Y'all always say, we know if we want to give you some pussy or not.
Right.
So if I tell you that I don't want to give you some pussy, you should know that I don't want to give you some fucking pussy. Because you've already had it established in your head, like, well, women already know if they want to sleep with you within the, you know, the first whatever, whatever, whatever.
Right.
You so
can't, you can't talk your
they
way.
Just be, they be playing if they don't or whatever. No, nigga, yeah. When I tell you I don't want to fuck, it's because I don't want to fuck. Leave me alone. Stop bringing that shit up to me.
You can't talk your way into pussy. You definitely talk your way out of it.
Because it's like, I laugh it off because I'm polite and I don't want to come off like a bitch and I don't want to just be like, bro, you never have a chance. Stop fucking talking to me
like
that.
Maybe that's what you should say.
I feel like I need to start.
Like, family just came back. Duh. At that point in time, the niceness should have been out the window.
Like, bro, stop requesting to see my goodies, fam. Don't you got something else to do?
Goodies, not my goodies.
Okay, because this is how it went.
Punch him.
He said, hey, pretty, was wondering if you wanted to collab and do a few scenes together. This was way back September 1st.
Oh, he been trying.
September 19th, because I never replied. He's like, what's up? I told him, I said, hey, sorry. I don't do scenes with people I'm not familiar with. I only have a handful of creators I work with. The rest are old flames. So everybody knew I was sick. He was like, well, how you feeling? Have you been getting better? And definitely understandable. But I'm sure we'll vibe good together. I don't know. We could FaceTime, talk more. We could link and smoke if you want. Just chop it up. Could just see how it goes if you want. It's definitely understandable, but see, whenever niggas start a butt in there, it's so you finna disregard everything that I just told you about. I don't work with new motherfuckers and be like, well, but I think you should give me a chance though. No.
He said, I know you don't do this, but you should give me a shot.
Right. I said, I'm feeling much better. I had COVID and pneumonia, so I was in the hospital a couple weeks. Finally up with some energy, so I'm probably about 85 to 90% now. Thanks for asking.
Now let me show you my dick. I feel like that's damn near where it went next.
No, so then is now it's October 2nd. When you go get to know me more, then so we can.
Oh my God, this guy is persistent.
Yeah. So Saturday, he like, see you always being me. I'm like, what is you talking about? You already know I don't be recruiting new people to work with. I ain't talking about recruiting. I'm already right here. You ain't got to recruit me. And you said, if you get to know me, we'll be good. But you never took the chance to get to know me. And anything that I just read, did I say anything about if you get to know me, then we could fuck?
Nope. Nah, you read between the lines.
I said no. I only said I don't do scenes with people I'm not familiar with. I never mentioned getting to know you. Then he called me rude.
Yeah, I don't know what
I said how. He was like, yeah, you bogus.
I don't know.
And this was yesterday. Now he like, so we won't ever make content? No, nigga. No. No, no.
I would like to know what...
Because even if I'm already turned off and don't want to work with you because I don't know you, the fact that you are not respecting the fact that I told you no and you keep doing this shit turns me off even more. So now, when you were at zero for having a chance with me, now you're at like negative 10. Now you're all the way down here. Damn. Because you keep making it fucking worse.
Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way down.
Dog, I hate you.
Shit, that's his life right now.
Fam, sync with that motherfucking hip on your vids. When you go realize you are a porn star. I realize it now. What they need to realize is I don't just fuck with motherfuckers because.
Now that she is a porn star that say that, how does that make you feel to know that you are really other people's fantasy? That's kind of dope, Logie.
It's not weird for me, though, because niggas have always fantasized about me because they couldn't see the pussy before. Now it's just, ooh, now I know what it looked like, so I really want it. So it's not new for me. And I'm not saying that in like a weird, cocky way. It's just niggas have always been like that with me for some reason. And I don't know why, because I've always been a nigga. Like, I've always been like one of the guys. So the fact that niggas have looked at me like that for so many years has always been odd to me.
They like tomboys.
I guess.
They like boy pussy.
Because the way I be watching TikTok and them tomboys be cleaning up kind
of
nice.
Hey, man, one of them studs. They really do.
She put one on came down my timeline.
Did she have dreads?
Yes.
I seen that one.
With the hat on.
Yeah. Yeah. She's a bad motherfucker.
She came through on business.
I was like, dog, tomboys and studs be fine as some motherfucking time.
She knew that motherfucker had around them to the end. It was oily to the motherfucker. Just sitting there like, ha. I was like, oh, okay.
Man.
Tom, all right, then, little dude.
Would you fuck a stud? Hey, bro. Yes. You probably have.
Yes, I have.
You a wild boy.
Everyone is not like, they don't all look like Manny Fresh right. or the Boosie, bro.
Okay, you know how Big Ja had that one skit about when he was fucking yeah. stuff? She didn't look like a stud. Right. She just acted very manly.
She cleaned up nice.
Same situation. I had known her for so long that her being a stud was just...
You always have to realize that there are studs like Tia Mac out there.
That's true. You know, studs went through this phase where all they wore was like polos and cargos, and they just dressed like Kanye West.
Speaking of which, I really want to ask my child, like, why is this Mexican plaid shirt in my fucking closet on top of my towel? Like,
your daughter, Essa.
Yes.
No, no comprende.
She been watching on my block.
Mi amiga.
Is she out here dressed like the Santos?
I'm not Hollywood because that has to do with my personal life outside of porn. Niggas have always been like that for some reason. I don't know why. Niggas have always wanted a piece of this ass. Niggas have always been on some fantasy shit. Niggas have always been weird with me. And to this day, I don't get it. I don't know why.
A conceited
Hollywood bitch would be like, yeah, because I'm that bitch. That's why they always... No, I don't understand why. I understand a little bit more now because I have OnlyFans. So they're like, all right, I see what that throw do. All right, I see how that ass move a little bit. Now I can understand it more than I could than back then. But niggas have always been weird like that.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, but I don't know.
When I get a girlfriend, she can't hang out with you.
Why?
Nigga, when you get a girlfriend, you gonna bring her around meet me for approval anyway.
Just because you meet her, don't mean you can hang out with her.
Who else you gonna hang out with, bro?
Not Mimi.
You're lying.
Right. You see the whole show stopped.
You are so lying.
You're gonna be a bad influence.
That might be true. That might be true. But you're not gonna not say that. Oh,
motherfucker, start be pregnant than a motherfucker fan.
Motherfucker start talking to you a certain way, like, where the fuck you get that shit from? Goddamn devil.
No, I'm not. Hey, Jada Fire actually blocked Monte.
Jada Fire is trash.
Because she asked him, he asked her questions about squirting on Twitter, and she got upset. Like, that's not what my Twitter is for, and blah 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 blah. Because she was talking about bagels and shit for breakfast. I was like, I don't give a fuck about that.
But I swear to God, I thought I seen her recently squirting on Twitter.
But no, I don't. I don't get mad because people come at me sexually. I know what I do. I know what my business is. I know that's what comes with it. What upsets me is the fact that niggas really, really, really feel like they have the juice and they don't. Like, get the fuck out of my DMs, bro. You ain't got enough money. Stanley. You don't. You don't see the niggas that DM me. If you saw the niggas that DM me and thought that they had a chance, then you'd be like, all right, bro, I get it. I understand, Mimi. I'm sorry. You're right. That nigga really should have known that he didn't have a chance. It'd be those type of niggas. It ain't some handsome ass content creator with a beautifully chiseled body and an oiled up dick that's coming at me and saying, hey, Cummer, would you like to collab with me? No.
So you
need, they be smooth. They be cool.
They need like his
resume. There's always some little perked up weirdo coming in talking about some, hey man, let's work. You are not a creator, bro. You are literally just DMing every bitch in Milwaukee with OnlyFans to see if they'll let you fuck. And that is perfectly fine, but it's not gonna work over here.
So he gotta show you like his resume, his stat sheet.
Joe said, fam, creeps are persistent and consistent. That is so true. Let me coming out here with this little sexy ass profile pic, Ash.
God damn.
Hey, Ash, what's up?
Hey, what's up? Ash, where my shirt at, fam?
Looking all glamorous and shit. She didn't have the colors that I wanted in the little dad hat.
Hey, Ash, get the crew together and slide through on Thursdays.
Okay. Can I get my shirt, please?
Did you order?
Yeah,
you did.
Just like you, bro. You know the quality of product that you make, right? Now, if somebody that has some real, just real janky ass shit came to you like, hey, bro, let's collab. Let's work on some shit. You would not be going for that shit. So don't be calling me Hollywood, because you know that you would be the same way.
I told you, you ain't never seen a nigga walk into Checkers and be like, hey, bro, I got you. I'm going to jump on these fries. You'll never see it. A nigga would never.
I feel like, man, give it to me. None of them niggas should hit anyway. And, you know, and that's one of the difficult things. That's actually one of the reasons why even guys that I would want to work with, I don't want to collab with them either. Because once they see you do any collabs, they automatically feel that they're on the level to collab with you, just because every nigga feels like he's better than the next nigga. So they automatically feel, oh, well, you collab with him so you can collab with me because I feel like I look better than him, or I feel like my dick is bigger than his, or I just feel like I got more sauce than dog. Well, in my eyes, you don't. So that's why he got the fucking you didn't, but I don't feel like having those arguments. Huh? So, yeah.
Because you let that nigga, that, I think that should be the name of this
that's
episode.
Really the, you let that nigga Terry bone. That's the name of this episode.
Because niggas really be on that.
Yes. Niggas are really fucking weird like that. And that is one of the reasons why I tell people, I'm like, look, like certain dudes, because I'll tell them, I'm like, you know, I like your work, you know, you are attractive or whatever, like, but this is the reason why I would rather not work, because I don't want a whole bunch of niggas flooding me and harassing me because I told them beforehand, no, I'm not going to work with you. Because some niggas have actually done that before. Come in my inbox like, oh, well, I see you doing collabs now, yada, 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 because I didn't want to work with them. If you don't get your long forehead ass out my fucking...
So,
I didn't want to fuck you. Just take it as that.
So as a porn star, when you compliment like somebody's work, like, how's that conversation going? Like,
oh, okay. So that's another thing.
I see you was getting that shit on the downstroke, bro. You call. Like, is that the conversation?
I'm not hearing nothing but you getting that shit on the downstroke.
No, I'm saying, oh, like, right. As a porn star, when you know, you compliment somebody's work. Like, yeah, you know, I seen you, bro.
I mean,
your downstroke kind of official. Do you kind of give him a tip like, no, you got to put your leg up on the other side?
No, but like, so that's another thing, right? As I don't even like to say the word. This is how Hollywood I'm not. I don't like to say porn star because I'm not a star. Like, that's not, I don't look at it like that.
She's a sex worker.
But exactly.
Trafficker.
But what bothers me is I do promo, okay? How do you get people interested in your OnlyFans? You promote it, you know? You post little clips and shit. Now, I am posting censored clips on Twitter because I know cheapskates. Niggas will follow you to get the clips, and then they don't want to subscribe because they're like, well, why pay? And I'm going to see, you know, free whatever. Now, for some niggas, it'll go the opposite. I'm like, damn, all right, I see what she could do. I'm going to go ahead and subscribe. But for the most part, niggas are freeloaders.
Hell
right?
Yeah, it don't take that long to beat your meat.
Yeah.
Nah, you don't understand how many times I've seen people say, why I pay for OnlyFans when there's free porn online?
Yeah.
I can scroll down Twitter and get off a nice session.
But you so, you know, so I promote like on Snapchat and shit too. You know what I'm saying? Like I post, you know, clips under a minute, censored, whatever. But for whatever reason, there are a lot of motherfuckers out there that feel like we do OnlyFans for compliments. For you to come and respond to my video with a compliment. I don't need your fucking compliment. I know how I swallowed it. Okay?
God.
I know what I do and I know how I do it.
That is so good.
Either you are going to subscribe or you're going to leave me the fuck alone. I don't need you to comment on every fucking video that I do, giving fucking heart eye emojis and all this other kind of shit. You want to send me a message, you subscribe to OnlyFans and you DM me there. Otherwise, stay the fuck out of my inbox. And I hate to sound like that, but motherfuckers will fucking heart eye emoji you to death. I don't want your fucking heart eye emoji. I can't fucking pay we energies with your heart eye emoji.
Yeah, I enjoy sending the heart eyes.
Says,
what's your favorite emoji?
Question, how does it feel to know that hella men and women that you actually know jack off to your scenes? You know what? Nothing surprises me anymore after a chick contacted me in Messenger to ask me why her boyfriend had my picture saved in his phone. I don't fucking know, lady. Now I'm creeped out because you just told me something. This nigga's saving my shit from Facebook.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Juan. Lately, my favorite one has been the wedding dress man. It has become quite hilarious to me.
Same bitches do, though. You are just not that type. Type for what? I said a lot in a short amount of time, so I don't know exactly what you're talking about. Yeah, I saw that.
That's not my man's, man. I don't know who that guy is.
It's not your man.
That's not my man.
That's your man's, bro.
Yeah, no, nah, no. Nah. Mike never.
While your boy out here being wild.
Yeah, but I don't need motherfuckers to always, damn, you sexy, ma, you this, you that. I'm not saying that compliments aren't appreciated, but it's just when it's the same motherfuckers all the time, it's like, bro, either you gonna fucking subscribe or not, because I don't need to talk to you every day.
Do they be
for you to tell me that you find me sexy or attractive or you like, man, I like the way you, okay, well, that's fine and dandy, but.
Do they be complimenting you like a New York nigga?
Don't start.
I just asked the question.
Hey, yo, son.
Yo, B. Yo. I like the cut of your jeans, man.
I didn't say he was jagging. What I said is nothing surprises me anymore after a woman contacted me to ask me why her nigga had my picture saved in his phone because he was saving my pictures from Facebook into his gallery on his phone. And she contacted me to ask me. I'm like, I don't fucking know. How am I supposed to know by your niggas? You clearly said that they're my Facebook pictures because you looked and saw what they were. So for you to know, and then when you do shit like that, our phone separates it. It puts it in an album that says Facebook. When you save pictures from Twitter, it puts them in an album for Twitter. Wherever you save them from, it lets you know.
So he had you.
So you come to me to ask me why your nigga is saving my social media pictures. Like I'm supposed to fucking know. Now I'm creeped out and I'm about to block both of you motherfuckers. You for writing me and him for being a weirdo.
You for sure weird. That's spank bank material.
But that's what bro just asked. He said, who the fuck is jagging to a picture?
You'd be surprised what these niggas is doing, fam.
Spank bank.
Look, man, I don't know what niggas doing. Niggas might be risking a paper cut and cutting a hole out my mouth and sticking their dick through it. I don't know.
That is horrible.
I told you, I don't put nothing past nobody. That motherfuckers sounds doing some weird shit.
Painful.
Sounds wild, dog.
Coming on a piece of paper is
no. It's the fact just the cutting out the mouth of a picture. I don't know what the reason was,
but don't fucking put me in that shit. That's some jail shit, fam.
That is some jail shit.
But when I was in jail, I used to read them little nasty erotic black novels and shit.
Hey, them just as bad.
You read all them Zane books,
man. Listen,
definitely got Zane and got you fucked up.
Tom, would you ever participate in the glory hole?
No, just wild.
I am so intrigued by those.
It's a wild concept because you don't know what's on the other side.
I think that would be the only way that I could fuck a big dick, ugly, or fat nigga. It would have to be a glory hole. I can't see anything but dick. Because I've said this on the show several times. I've said this on my pages several times. I don't care how big, thick, and juicy your dick is. Once I see your face, and if I don't like it, I'm no longer attracted to it.
In the word of the pod god, stop talking.
So it would have to be a glory hole, bro.
On pod god.
Like that would be the only way for me to just be like, oh man, this is some good ass dick, because I don't know who's on the other side of it.
I hate you.
Like, cause once I know you ugly, it's like, bro, I don't care. Get away from me. It might as well be little and uncircumcised at this point, because I don't want nothing to do with it.
All right, and we've come to the end of this particular show. Thank you for tuning in, because Mimi, I'm sick of her shit.
For sure.
Whatever. Well, since they're kicking me off the air, and I don't have any penis to go get to, and we did start a little bit late today, I do want to thank you guys for coming out and joining us, whether you are a viewer or if you are going to stream us on Tuesday, because, you know, some of y'all be needing us to get through your workday. But hey, make sure you shop www.cummerscandycloset.com for all of your adult toy, lingerie, and novelty needs. Fellas, I did not forget about you guys. We have male masturbators, pocket pussies. We got all of the shit for your deep throat and massage oils. I got everything. BDSM, got your cuffs, your spreader bras, whatever you need. Use sex swings in the dance pole. Cummer's Candy Closet, bro.
Hey, are your poles the ones that just screw into the top or the ones that are retractable?
You screw them in.
Okay. Because, you know, we ain't got no furniture in the front room right now, so definitely enough space for a good pole action.
Yeah, I don't know.
We turning your living room into a shake joint.
Might as well, fam. It's just me and her next weekend.
Right. Hey, do what you got to do, man.
Tom, you a filthy nigga.
So,
I hate you, dog.
And you can also subscribe to my OnlyFans. I am currently running a 30% off special right now for new and expired subscribers. So that is $13.13. For the next 30 days.
So this is like your Cocktober special?
Yes.
Boom. Yes. You got to give me something on that one.
Yes.
Cocktober.
Boom. Cocktober.
Yes, it is.
I'm not even mad at that.
Cocktober,
bro.
And Swalloween. You saw that meme?
Yeah,
I saw that. Yeah. So again, make sure you are tuned in to my OnlyFans, because I have been dropping content like crazy. I have a consistent content partner again, and we have been getting shit in. So 1 week I dropped like 5 videos.
You should fuck him with a pumpkin on his head.
No,
it's you want me to knot him up, bro?
Hey,
just get him a pumpkin mask.
Oh, hey. I thought you meant like a pumpkin head. Like,
no, bro, don't whoop his ass.
Hey, make the nigga wear a Michael Myers mask.
End of hot girl.
Don't ruin my
hot girl summer.
You're not gonna watch it.
I don't want to know what happened.
This she won't tell you.
Why are you trying to ruin Mike for me?
Hey,
and as you know,
mask
next week, well, not even next week, because this is Sunday now. So this coming weekend is Sweetest Day weekend. So make sure y'all shout with me for your Sweetest Day supplies. Like I said, I got your handcuffs. I got your rose petals. I got your massage oils. I got all of the filthy shit you need. So make sure y'all get up with me. Local delivery to select 532 zip codes. Now, I get a lot of questions about this, and I want to address this real quick. I don't deliver outside of the city of Milwaukee. So if you are in Oak Creek, Brookfield, any of those places, I do not deliver to those areas. Now, unfortunately for some of you that are in the city of Milwaukee, your zip codes have been excluded because you share them with other municipalities. For example, I believe is it 53214? I think they are city of Milwaukee, but they also share with West Dallas and West Milwaukee. So because of that, I had to kind of take it out, because some people had me driving. Because
they do that with Glendale.
With, you know, buttfuck Iowa and shit. So they had me driving all, like, bro, I went all like deep in South Milwaukee with no tip. I came home and I changed my delivery route. After that, that was it. I was driving for a long ass time, bro. Like past Patrick Cudahy and all of that shit out that way. Like I was deep south, and I didn't even get a tip. And I said, hey, you know what? We're going to go ahead and change this to mostly on the north side. So that's what I did. I had body paint on there. People weren't really, they weren't buying it. So I ended up, taking it off, because it was an edible body paint too. So, you know, y'all didn't even have to wash it off. Like, you just lick it off the nipples and shit.
Oh, that's fire.
Yeah. So I might bring that back. We'll see. Because, I mean, everything is trial and error. if there are products that you guys are interested in that you don't see on the website, do not hesitate to hit me up. Let me know, whether you hit me on Messenger, send me an email or whatever, and say, hey, you know, are you going to be getting this in or whatever? And I can try to get that in for you. You know, it's just, I try to keep a lot of the most popular themes that I know a lot of people are into. Once I do slide into a retail location, it'll be a lot easier. People can kind of come in and shop and see what they like. But I really, really, really want y'all to expand y'all horizons and get as nasty as you can and stop worrying about people judging you. So, again, that website is right there in your lower right corner. If you are streaming, it is www.cummerscandycloset.com, where you can get all of your adult toys, lingerie, sensual items, BDSM, and more. So until next time, we gotta go.